Good evening, everyone. Welcome, parents, to our annual Advent show. We are so happy to be gathered here today. We weren't sure if this was going to be able to happen. So even though we don't have all our parents here tonight, I'm glad that we were able to invite our eighth grade parents and have you here for your child's last Advent show. As you know, this is a long-standing tradition, and as I mentioned, we're very happy that we're able to be here tonight. So thank you. The kids have practiced long and hard. The teachers have been supporting them, practicing with them, so you're in for a very special treat tonight. I'm going to invite Father Fulton to give us a blessing, and we will begin our presentation.
Good evening, welcome again. So, as Mrs. Rivera said, it's a beautiful opportunity to prepare ourselves for Christmas and to remind ourselves what is going to happen and what should happen in our hearts. So we want to prepare ourselves spiritually, and we prepare ourselves spiritually when we pray. So I would like to invite everyone to stand up and pray for our academy, for those who are going to perform, for ourselves, for the big family of St. Agnes, and say together, Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Enjoy the show.
It is our honor to welcome you on behalf of the class of 2022. We are happy to have this opportunity, after a year full of trials, to end this year on a positive note.
Tonight's performance will be another wonderful way to worship and honor our Savior Jesus Christ and spread light and hope through our St. Agnes community and beyond.
2,000 years ago, people found hope in a star. This Christmas, let us help each other to find hope in Christ like kindness. As we prepare for the coming of the Lord, we are offering you through this performance gifts of love, peace, and joy.
The class of 2022 will be your guides through Christmas stories, which define the birth of Christ and prepare us for this special season. The students from 5th, 6th, and 7th grade will be joining us with glorious music. Let their voices ring with love and joy of the season.
No matter if you are connected through our channel or present here, do not forget you are a big part of this performance. So let our voices ring with love and joy of the season.
And now, without further ado, let us start our performance.
Thank you. But before that, someone had to prepare the way for him. His parents, Elizabeth, Mary's cousin, and her husband, Zacharias.
When they returned from having their baby dedicated in Jerusalem, they brought an astonishing announcement with them.
Come in, come in. It is so good to be back in heaven, dear friends. I am so touched by your kindness and prayers during these years of barrenness. And now.
In truth, not all prayed for her during those years.
Well, as you can hear, the rumors are true. Zacharias has regained his voice. God is gracious. And Zacharias, how can they understand unless you tell them that you lost your voice?
Yes, yes, you are right, Elizabeth. For I have been chosen to burn incense before the Lord. Once a glorious man appeared before me. I fell to my knees in fear, but he said, do not be afraid. Your prayers have been heard.
After 30 years of prayers. So you see, friends, keep praying. Don't give up.
John will be the ones to go before the Messiah and prepare the people to receive him.
Tell them that you lost your voice, old man.
Yes, how can I be sure? I am too old. My wife is beyond childbearing. Gabriel said that our son will be, that I will be unable to speak until the day our son was born. This was a sign for me.
And a rest for me.
You see, all we ever wanted was a son.
Not a prophet. To raise and watch him grow and have a family of his own.
Did God do what we asked?
And are we disappointed?
No.
All our prayers were for God to give us what we want.
We never thought we'd be in a position to give God what he wanted.
So when I went to the temple to dedicate our baby, I told them, his name is John. But the high priest said no. The first son should be named after his father.
Slain, my tongue was free, and I shouted, John! John!
And then he prophesied. My husband prophesied. For all that John will do to prepare the way for the Messiah, I still can hardly take it in. Yet there he lies.
Our son, God's gift, to us,
our gift to God.
True king was being born.
But then pride and control are challenges to everyone.
Even before the Messiah was born, God challenged people to make room for him in their hearts.
Abraham stopped everything to make room for Melchizedek, the king of righteousness.
King David, a man after God's own heart, longed to build a house for him.
Isaiah, who prophesied the coming of our Savior, urged us to make a way for him.
But on the eve of the Messiah's birth, in Bethlehem, there was no room for his parents, Mary and Joseph.
Sir, please, sir, do you have a room?
No, we don't have any space available. Ah, but I suppose you're gonna say relatives. Suddenly, everyone's related to us.
Jake, who is it?
More relatives.
What?
You're here for census, right? And so you came to the inn. Ah, one large extra room, and that makes us the official inn at Bethlehem in Judea.
Please excuse my husband. 4 or 5 times a year, a traveler will come.
Which he will pay us, sometimes quite low.
But because of the census, Bethlehem is overrun and we're so crowded that we're turning people away in droves, even some relatives.
Some who are closely related to me, as my camel. Thank you. Alright, bye. At least he was willing to pay a good money.
Money skimmed from the purses of poor and rich Judeans. And what does he do for a nice young couple from Nazareth?
What? I gave him the other room.
Other room. It's a stable.
It's a room.
It's a cave.
A cave in which people sometimes sleep.
It's where we keep the animals.
What? You love animals.
She's pregnant, Jane. A girl should not have to give birth next to donkeys and oxen. It's not clean. It's unhealthy.
What do you want for free?
They're your relatives.
A cousin of a cousin of a cousin.
Didn't you feel the tugging at your heart when they came to our door?
I felt the tugging in my coin pouch when the tax collector dropped 6 denarii in it.
There are different kinds of wealth. I really just think we passed over a blessing. There could have been new life in this house.
I may have seen something. Still, it was
inconvenient.
I was going to say possible. You know I had no choice.
You had a choice.
What, to turn away a good man with money?
We could have stayed in the stable, chain.
Impossible, it's winter. You know how my back gets. And you yourself said, it's not clean, it's unhealthy.
I would have lived. We would have lived. I do love animals. And besides, God gives us the grace to do the
inconvenient.
It's going to say impossible.
Well, let us find them and put them in the stable. And we have no more room, even if you could pay.
Ask yourselves, was there really no room for Jesus' family in the scene you just saw?
I hope you would reflect upon what does it mean for you to make room for Jesus in your heart.
Yeah.
the early morning at the marketplace, in the bustling sheep trading center, three young shepherds came.
2,000 years ago, God chose to announce the royal birth of his son to shepherds. Why did he do that? Is it surprising? But I know Jesus said, "My sheep hear my voice, and I know them, and they follow me."
We are his flock, and he is our shepherd.
Thank you. this is your opportunity to step into the stable and cradle your arms, the infant Jesus. The word of God entered the world as a cry of a baby.
The Christmas story is first and foremost a human story, where God writes a story with ordinary people like Joseph and like Mary, people like you and people like me.
Dear Gus, we are happy that you came tonight to share this evening with us. We hope you liked your presentation and enjoyed it.
May you be blessed with the Christmas season. Please join us in our traditional song, Celebrate. Thank you and good night. Happy Christmas.
Present you with us.
once again, and thank you, parents, for joining us tonight. We hope you enjoyed this very beautiful celebration, and we wish you all a season filled with much hope, faith, joy, peace, and love. Have a wonderful Advent season and a Merry Christmas. Thank you.